If this were easy to solve, someone would have already solved it. About a third of the world's population is at risk of malaria. There are over 200 million new cases each year and over 500,000 deaths, primarily in children in Africa each year. Malaria is an infection caused by a protozoan parasite. It invades the human first by the bite of a mosquito and then goes to the liver and then goes to the red cell. My lab focuses really on understanding the parasite and the parasite's biology through the lens of genomics. It's really using genomics to understand how the parasite overcomes drugs, develops resistance or tolerance to drugs, and how the parasite is able to evade the human immune system. We have collaborations in countries all over the world. Our students have the opportunity to participate in work in natural settings and then come back to the lab and apply cutting-edge genomic, cell biological, molecular biological techniques to really eradicate the disease in the areas that are most affected. One is going to need something that's long-acting, and there, I think the opportunity for discovery and development of an effective vaccine is the most important innovation. You know, it's a challenge. There's no question that it's a challenge, but malaria is not a disease that afflicts people with great wealth. It is a disease of poverty, and thus, progress in malaria is going to depend on universities and governmental funding because it doesn't have a private sector profit that could be used to develop innovation. So I think Harvard has both a responsibility and an opportunity to make great advances in this field.